charine nirvisesha shunyavadi paschacya desha tarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're on Canto 6, chapter number 8. Right? Chapter number 8 is called the Narayana Kavacha Shield.
We're going to hear
about a mantra which was given to protect the demigods from the demons.
这个是, 这个一个曼陀罗用来保护半神免受恶魔的攻击的
The demigods had been defeated by the demons, and so the problem was they didn't have a guru.
半神人在之前被恶魔所打败，由于他们原因是他们之前没有灵性导师。
So they went to Lord Brahma, and Lord Brahma told them that they should take this man Vishwarup as their guru.
于是半神人就去找主 Brahma, 主 Brahma 建议他们去找 Vishwarupa 作为他们的guru.
And so they talked to Vishwarupa and he agreed to help them.
他们于是就跟 Vishwarupa 提出这一请求, Vishwarupa 也答应帮助他们.
And he told them about the Narayana Kavacha mantra, which could protect them from their enemies and help them to conquer their enemies.
于是维舍鲁帕就给了他们这个 Narayana Kavacha, 可以保护他们免于敌人的攻击。
So when Maharaj Parikshit heard about this, then he asked Sukadeva Goswami, he said, oh, tell me about this Narayana Kavacha.
当 Maharaj Parikshit 他听到了这一个事情之后, 他就向苏卡德瓦 Goswami 询问, 他说, 请你来告诉我关于这个 Narayana Kavacha.
I want to hear about this mantra, how it helped Lord King Indra to defeat the demons, to defeat his enemies.
我想知道这个 Indra 他是怎么样打败他的敌人的。
His enemies were trying to kill him, they wanted to kill Indra. But Indra was able to defeat them.
这些敌人他们都想杀了Indra, 但是Indra击败了他们。
So Sukadeva Goswami told Indra, he said, well, this is a Vishnu mantra known as the Narayana Kavacha, and it came from Vishwarup.
Sukadeva Goswami 就来描述, 他说这是一个Vishnu的曼陀罗, 叫Narayana Kavacha, 他是Vishwarupa来, 给予这些半神人的。
And Vishwarupa, the demigods had taken Vishwarupa as their priest, as like their guru.
半神人现在接受Vishwarupa作为他们的
Originally, the guru of the demigods is Brihaspati, but Brihaspati had been offended by Indra's behavior and he went away and left them.
之前他们的灵性导师是Brihaspati, 但是由于Indra对他的冒犯, 导致Brihaspati离开了半神人们。
So now Sukadeva Goswami is going to tell us this mantra.
现在Sukadeva Goswami 准备给我们讲述这个曼陀罗。
So Vishwarup said, if, if there's some kind of fear, if you have some kind of fear, then you should first wash your hands and legs clean, and you should do akshman.
维什瓦如帕说, 倘若恐惧的某种形体来临时, 人应当首先做一个净化仪式。
And he told the mantra, you must have all heard this mantra at the time of initiation when we do fire yagya, we chant this mantra.
你们大多数都听过这个曼陀罗，在你们做起立仪式的时候都会唱诵这个曼陀罗。
When you do the akshman, at the time of doing akshman, you have to chant this mantra.
在你们做这个净化的时候，你们都会唱诵这个曼陀罗。
Om pavitra pavitra va sarvavastam gato piva yasmarat pundarikaksham sabhayantara suchi Shri Vishnu Shri Vishnu Shri Vishnu. So that's the mantra. And when you do that, when you say that mantra, then you should touch kusha grass, and you have to sit facing the north.
当你唱诵这个曼陀罗的时候，我们应该触碰枯沙草，然后面北而坐。
And then you should touch the mantra of eight syllables to the eight parts of the body.
然后应当用这首八个音节的曼陀罗触碰身体的八个部分。
And then touch the mantra of 12 syllables to the hands.
用12个音节组成的曼陀罗触碰双手。
And then he should bind himself with the Narayana Kavach, with the Narayana Kavacha.
用这样的方法让自己和Narayana这个盔甲外套结合在一起。
So the mantra of eight syllables is Om Namo Narayanaya.
八个音节组成的这个曼陀罗叫 Om Namo Narayana.
Narayanaya.
Narayanaya.
So you begin with the first syllable, Om, and you touch that, touch hands to the eight parts of the body.
以Om为开始，用手触碰身体的八个部分。
And start with the 2 feet, and then progress to the knees, and then to the thighs, and then to the stomach.
以双足开始，逐渐上升到双膝、双腿、肚脐、心脏、胸膛、口和头。
Yeah. And then you should chant the mantra in reverse order.
然后再返回来唱诵这首曼陀罗。
And you begin with the syllable ya.
以从最后一个音节ya开始。
And the last one will be om.
而最后的一个音节应该是om.
And you touch the parts of the body in the reverse order.
然后再唱诵。 然后触碰身体的其他个部分。
And then you should chant the mantra of the 12 syllables.
然后再以唱诵这个12个音节的曼陀罗。
And this is a mantra everybody knows. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
这个12个音节组成的曼陀罗大家都知道是 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
So, before each syllable, you have to say Om.
在每一个音节开始都是 Om.
And then you should place the syllable of the mantra on the tips of the fingers.
在唱每一个曼陀罗的每一个音节的时候，都应该放在指尖上。
And begin with the index finger of the right hand.
从右手的食指开始。
And finish with the index finger on the left hand.
以左手的食指为结束。
And then the four remaining syllables, because that's only eight, there's four remaining, this is 12 syllable mantra, so there's four more syllables, and they're placed on the joints of the thumb.
因为从右手的食指开始到左手的食指结束是八个，然后这是一个十二个音节的曼陀罗，所以还剩四个，其余的四个音节应该在拇指的关节上。
So it sounds quite complicated in the beginning, but after you do it a lot of times, if you do it every day, you get used to it.
在我们最开始听这个程序的时候是有点复杂的，但是如果你每天做的话，就会很熟悉。
Then you have to chant the mantra of six syllables.
现在就应该唱诵六个音节的曼陀罗。
That's Om Vishnave Namaha.
这个曼陀罗是 Om Vishnave Namaha.
So you place the syllable Om on the heart.
把音节 Om 放在心脏。
And then the syllable V on the top of the head.
音节 V 放在头顶。
And then Sa between the eyebrows.
音节 Sa 置于两眉之间。
And then the syllable Na on the Sika.
音节 Na 放在 Sika 上。
And the syllable V between the eyes.
音节 V 置于两眼之间。
And then you should place the syllable Na on all the joints of the body.
把这个Na 这个音节放在躯体的所有关节之上。
And you should meditate on the syllable Ma as being a weapon.
然后冥想 Ma 这个音节作为一件武器。
And in this way, we should become like a personification of the mantra.
这样就把这首曼陀罗变成一个完美的人格化身。
And then the final syllable ma, you have to add the visarga. Ma.
在最后一个
Right?
在最后一个音节 ma 上加上 visarga.
You should chant the Ma Astrapat in all directions.
在所有的，他应该向所有的方向唱诵这首曼陀罗。Ma Astrayapat.
Beginning from the east.
从东方开始。
And then all the directions will be covered by the mantra.
从东方开始，然后所有的方向将都被这首曼陀罗捆绑。
Then, after you've done this chanting, then you should think, you should meditate on yourself as being qualitatively one with the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
在结束唱诵这些曼陀罗之后，一个人应当冥想自己在品质上与至尊主是合一的。
And we think of the Supreme Personality of Godhead with six opulences.
我们知道至尊人格守神本人他有六项的绝对富裕。
And then there's a special prayer which we should make to Lord Narayan.
也应该有一个特别的曼陀罗去冥想 Narayan。
And this is the actual Kavacha, this prayer.
这个 Narayan 的 Kavacha 其实也是一个祈祷文。
So it begins describing how the Lord sits on the back of Garuda.
这里描述到主他是如何坐在 Garuda 的身上的，大鸟 Garuda.
And the Lord has eight weapons, and he's holding different weapons like the conch shell, the disc, shield, sword, club, arrows, bow, and ropes.
主坐在 Garuda 上，身上有八件武器，这八件武器分别是海螺、神蝶、盾、剑、棒、剑，这个弓箭的箭，以及弓，还有绳索。
So then we should pray to the Supreme Personality of Godhead to protect me at all times with his eight arms.
愿那位至尊人格守神以他的八臂形象总是无时无刻地保护着我。
He is all powerful because he possesses the eight mystic powers.
他是全然有力的，因为他全然拥有八种玄秘的力量。
Okay, so part of this meditation, we have to think of ourselves as being one with the Supreme. So this, that process, that is called Ahangrahopasana.
认为自己与至尊主同一的这个叫做 Ahangrahopasana.
So this process, Ahangrahopasana doesn't mean that we become God, but we have to think of ourselves as qualitatively one with God.
这个程序并不是与主合一的这个程序并不是说人变成的这个神而是要认为自己在品质上与至尊主是同一的
And we have the same qualities as the Supreme Lord just like a drop of water has the same qualities as the ocean
我们和至尊主在品质上一样就像一滴水和海水，就是说一海里面的一滴水和整个海水，它的本性是一样的。
And we should meditate on the Supreme Lord, as it's described here, and pray for His protection.
我们应当这样，像这节诗中那样去冥想着至尊主，寻求他的保护。
So we always have to want to get the mercy of the Supreme Lord.To be protected. That's how we can be protected. We have to pray for His mercy.
我们应该总想着能够得到至尊主的保护，能够得到他的仁慈。
So then the prayer continues. Is that the Narayana Kavacha says, "May that Lord who takes the body of a big fish protect me in the water."
这个祈祷文继续说道。愿化身为一条巨鱼形象的主在水中保护我，不是保护我。
There are many fierce animals in the water, and they may be associates of the demigod Varuna.
在水中有很多凶猛的动物，凶猛的动物，它们或许是 Varuna 的同游。
And we know also the Lord sometimes.Uses his illusory energy, and he takes the form of a dwarf called Vamanadev.
我们的主有时候经常会使用他的迷幻能量，他也会化身为 Vamanadev 的这个形体。
So we pray to Lord Vamanadev to protect us on the land.
愿主 Vamanadev 在陆地上保护我。
And then there's a form of the Lord called Vishwarup, where he conquers the three worlds. So we pray to him to protect us in the sky.
愿主的这个 Vishwarupa 的这个形体能够在天空中保护我。
So you can see praying to these different personalities to protect us in different situations.
我们向主的不同的形体在不同的条件下寻求他的保护。
The Lord in the form of fish is Matsya, that he can protect us in water.
主的鱼的形体是 Matsya.
And he will protect us in the water.
他能够在水中保护我们。
And Lord Vamanadev protects us in the sky.
主 Vamanadev 在天空中保护我们。
Oh no, Vamanadev protects us on the earth.
主 Vamanadev 是在地球表面上保护我们。
And Vishwarup protects us in the sky.
Vishwarup 是在天空中保护我们。
So next you pray to Lord Nrisingadev, who is the enemy of Hiranyakashipu, and we pray that he will protect me in all directions.
祷文接下来说，愿这个黑人亚卡西普的敌人 主力辛哈德瓦在各个方向上保护着我。
When Lord Nrisimhadeva laughed, his laughter was so loud it vibrated everywhere, and it caused the pregnant wives of the demons to have a miscarriage.
当主力辛哈德瓦在高声大笑的时候，他震撼到四面八方，令恶魔的这些妻子们都流产。
And so we pray to Lord Nrisimhadeva to protect us in difficult places, like in the forest and on the battlefield.
愿主能够在，当我们处在一种很困难处境的情况下的时候，能够保护我们。比如说，我们在森林或前线战争的前线的这些危难之处的时候，主能够保护我们。
Then there's a form of the Lord called Yagneshwara, who oversees the performance of ritualistic sacrifices.
主有一个形体叫 Yageshvara， 它是通过祭祀仪式可以被探知的。
And then the Lord appears as Lord Varaha, Lord Boar, and he picked up the earth from the bottom of the universe.
主还有一个形体叫 Varaha 的这个雄猪形体。他能够把地球从宇宙的底部中托起。
So we pray to Lord Varaha to protect us from the rogues who are there on the street.
愿主Varaha这个Varaha能够保护我不受街上的这些恶棍侵扰。
And may Parasuram protect us on the top of the mountains.
愿 Parasurama 在山巅保护我。
And may Lord Ramachandra.Along with his brother Lakshman, protect me in foreign countries.
愿 Bharata 的哥哥主 Ramachandra 连同他的兄弟 Lakshman 在异国他乡保护我。
Then they pray to Lord Narayan to protect us from unnecessarily being influenced by false religion.
愿主 Narayana 保护我免受这就是保护我不必要的去追随虚假的宗教体制。
And may he protect me from falling, from giving up my duties, becoming mad.
愿他保护我不会由于疯狂而从我的职责之中堕落。
And in his form as Nara, as in form as Nara, will he please protect me from unnecessary pride?
愿显现为 Nara 的这个主，保护我免于不必要的骄傲。
And Lord Dattatreya, he's a master of all mystic power. May he protect me from falling from Bhakti Yoga.
愿主 Dattatreya, 他是所有玄秘力量之主，希望他能够保护我在旅行奉爱瑜伽时不要堕落。
And Lord Kapila will he should protect me from the material bondage of material activities.
愿主卡皮拉保护我免于功利性活动的物质束缚。
And Sanat Kumar, one of the four Kumaras, please protect me from lusty desires.
愿 Sanat Kumar, 四位 Kumar 之一，愿他保护我免于色欲。
And may Lord Hai Griva, may he protect me from being an offender by not offering proper respect to Krishna.
愿主 Hai Griva 在保护我，愿主 Hai Griva 保护我，不会因为。忽视向至尊主致敬顶拜而成为冒犯者。
And may Narada Muni protect me from committing offenses in worshipping the deity.
愿 Narada Muni 保护我在做神像崇拜的时候不做冒犯。
And then pray to Lord Kurma, who is the Lord in the form of a tortoise, to protect me from falling into the hellish planets.
愿那位乌龟形象的这个主库尔玛保护我免于跌落至无尽的地狱星宿之中。
So, you know, lusty desires are very strong in everyone, and there's a big obstacle in our devotional service.
每一个人身上的色欲都十分强大, 它是我们在旅行, 在从事奉献服务之中的最大障碍。
So for people who are very lusty, they should take shelter of Sanat Kumar.
一个深陷色欲影响的人, 他应该脱避于 Sanat Kumar.
He was a great brahmachari.
他是一个伟大的真守身奉献者。
Of course, he solved the problem. He never grew old. He remained always a young boy.
当然他解决了问题, 他总是保持一个 年轻的男孩的形象，他从来没有长大。
And we pray to Narada Muni to protect us from offenses in the deity worship, because Narada Muni, he is expert in worshiping the deity.
我们向Narada Muni祈求，我们在做神像崇拜时要避免，能够避免冒犯，因为Narada Muni他非常擅长于崇拜神像。
There's a book called Narada Pancharatra, which all about the rules and principles how to worship the deity.
有一本书叫《Narada Pancharatra》, 这本书就是关于在崇拜神像时所有的规范原则。
So anybody who is worshipping the deity, either at your home or in the temple, you should always pray for the mercy of Devarshi Narada.
因此，每一位从事于神像崇拜的奉献者，无论他是在庙里还是在自己的家里，他都应该祈求得到Devashi Narada Muni的仁慈。There
are 32 offenses in deity worship, and they're all mentioned in our book Nectar of Devotion.
崇拜神像时有32项应该小心的冒犯，这些都在分外的甘露之中提到了。
So then next, we pray to the incarnation of the Lord as Dhanvantari to help me, to stop me eating undesirable things, and to protect me from illness.
祈求他拯救我免于不良的食物，就是不渴望的食物，祈求他保护我没有躯体的疾病。And
then pray to Lord Rishabhdev to conquer the senses, the inner senses and the outer senses.
祈求主 Rishabhdev 能够保护我。
And protect me from the fear due to the heat and the cold.
保护我摆脱由冷和热产生的二重性带来的恐惧。
And then pray to Lord Yagna. Lord Yagna is another name for the Supreme Lord, to protect me from getting a bad name or being harmed by the people.
愿Yagya保护我不受众人的诽谤和伤害。And
then Lord Balaram, and who's also Shesha, may he protect us from envious snakes.
愿主Balaram能够作为Shesha保护我不受毒蛇的噬咬。So
in the material world, there's always many dangers, and one of the dangers is different types of food which we shouldn't eat, which is not good for our health.
在这个物质世界总是有很多困难，在这里，其中一个困难，其中一个危难就是总是有一些并不对我们的健康并不太好的一些食物。So
the Lord in His form is Dhanvantari, He can protect us from this problem.
主的丹曼他人的这个化身可以在这个方面保护我们。And
Lord Vishnu is also the super soul, so he can protect us from problems due to other living entities.
主威士努是众生的超灵，他能够保护我们免受其他生物体的骚扰。
And Lord Balaram, in his Shesha incarnation, he can protect us from angry snakes and also from envious persons who are always trying to attack us.
主 Balaram 是 Shesha 的化身，他可以拯救我们不受愤怒的这些蛇以及嫉妒之人的攻击。
So then next we pray to Vyasadeva to protect us from all kinds of ignorance.
下面我们请我们向我们祈求 Vyasadeva 保护我们免于各种各样的愚昧。
We're in ignorance because we don't have the Vedic knowledge.
我们之所以愚昧是因为我们没有伟大知识。
And then we pray to Lord Buddha to protect us from activities against the Vedic principles.
我们祈求主佛为布达佛祖保护我们不做违背伟大原则的活动。
And we pray to Buddha also to protect us from laziness that causes us to forget the Vedic principles.
我们祈求佛祖保护我们也能够免于这种懒惰的这种不好的习惯。
And then we pray to Kalki, who is the personality of Godhead, to protect religious principles and protect us from the age of Kali.
我们愿主 Kalki 能够保护我们免受卡利年代的污染。
So, in this verse, in this mantra, there's different incarnations mentioned, like Srila Vyasadeva, who composed all the Vedas.
在这个时节里面描述了各种各样主的化身，比如说 Vyasadeva 他编纂的所有的伟大经。
So if we want to be protected from ignorance, we should read the books which Srila Vyasadeva has written.
如果我们想去除自己的愚昧的话，我们应该读圣 Vyasadeva 写的这些所有的伟大经。
Like the four Vedas, the 108 Upanishads, the Mahabharata, Srimad
Bhagavatam, Brahma Sutra, Mahabharata, and Shengdian Bodhyavatam.
So it's Srila Vyasadeva's mercy that we have so many scriptures to read.
These are Shri Vyasadeva's mercy, giving us so many scriptures
Protect us from ignorance.
能够保护我们免于愚昧。
So when Lord Buddha was preaching, he was not in favor of the Vedic knowledge.
当主佛陀显现的时候，他并不对伟大知识并不友好。
So Lord Buddha, he wanted to save the people from killing animals.
主佛陀的显现，他是希望人们能够从杀动物的这一恶境之中拯救出来，摆脱出来。
At that time, there were many people in the name of the Vedas who were killing animals.
在那个年代，很多人假借伟达经之名来杀动物。
So that was why Lord Buddha said, I don't accept the Vedas, because the Vedas allows killing animals.
所以这就是佛陀他说，我不接受伟达经，因为伟达经允许杀动物。
So in this way, Lord Buddha, he saved people from doing sinful activities.
以这样的方式，佛陀来拯救了那些罪恶的人。
So, if we surrender to Lord Buddha, it can help people who are misguided about what is the actual instructions of the Vedas.
如果一个人能恰当的臣服主佛陀的话，他能够帮助人，避免误用伟大经的训诫。
Because people were thinking the Vedas say it's okay to kill the animals, so they were killing the animals.
因为当时的人们觉得，哦，伟达经说可以杀动物，于是， 于是哦，我们杀动物是可行的。
So then the Kalki avatar, he kills all the atheists. At the end of the Kali Yuga, he kills all the atheists.
在卡利年代的末尾 ，Kalki 这个化身，他杀掉了，他杀掉了所有的无神论者。
But it, you know, as Kali Yuga goes on, there will be more and more false religious systems.
随着卡利年代不断的往前推进，越来越多的假的宗教原则引进出来。
People forget the real principles of religion given by Lord Krishna.
人们忘记了由 Krishna 颁布的这些真正的宗教原则。
That we're supposed to surrender to Krishna.
我们本应该去臣服主 Krishna.
All right, and then the next one, the prayer is to Lord Keshava to protect me with his club.
愿主 Keshava 能够保，能够用他的这个棒槌保护我。
That's during the first portion of the day.
这个是在白昼的第一个部分。
And then may Govinda, who is always playing his flute, protect me in the second portion of the day.
愿主 Govinda, 恒常吹奏笛子的 Govinda, 在白天的第二个部分保护我。
And then Lord Narayan, who has all the potencies, protect me in the third part of the day.
愿具有所有力量的主 Narayana 在白天的第三个部分保护我。
And may Lord Vishnu, who carries a disc to kill the enemies, protect me in the fourth part of the day.
愿能够杀死敌人的主 Vishnu 在白天的第四个部分保护我。
So this is the Vedic system. They divide the day into different divisions like that. Not just 12 hours.
这是伟达的计算方法，它不是说分成十二个小时，而是把一天分为四个部分。
Yeah, the in the Vedas it's divided into periods of 24 minutes.
伟达是是24分钟作为一个阶段。
Each day and each night is divided into 6 parts.
每一个白天和每一个夜晚都分成六个部分。
And each part has 5 periods of 24 minutes.
每一个部分包括五个二十四分钟。
So in each of these 6 portions of the day and night, then Krishna can be addressed for protection by different names.
在白天和黑夜的每一个部分都可以根据不同的名主的不同的根据不同的名字呼唤主的保护。
So the first person we call to is Lord Keshava. Lord Keshava is he's the master of Mathura. There's a famous temple of Lord Keshava in Mathura.
所以白天的第一个部分的主的我们呼唤的是主 Keshava, 他是 Mathura 的一个拥有者，他是 Mathura 的拥有者。
And then the Lord of the second portion of the day is Govinda, and Govinda is the Lord of Vrindavan.
第二个部分的主人是 Govinda, 他也是 Vrindavan 的主人。
So then pray to Lord Madhusudan.Who carries a bow, very fearful to the demons, to protect me during the fifth part of the day.
愿持有一张弓的马杜苏的呢保护我。他在白天的第五个部分，愿他能够保护我。
And in the evening, may Lord Madhava, who appears as Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh, protect me in the beginning of the night.Not the beginning. Just protect me in the evening.
在傍晚愿显现为主 Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara 的主 Madhava 保护我。
But in the beginning of the night, we pray to Rishikesha to protect us.
在夜晚之初，愿主 Rishikesha 保护我。
And at the dead of night, the second and the third part of the night, pray to Lord Padmanabha to protect me.
在夜晚的第二个部和第三个部分，愿主 Padmanabha 保护我。
And then pray to Sri Vatsa.The mark of Sri Vatsa is on the chest of the Lord. So may the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has this mark of Sri Vatsa on his chest, protect me after midnight.
愿在胸前印有 Sri Vatsa 标志的至尊人格守神，在午夜过后直到保护我。
May he protect me until the sky becomes pinkish in the morning.
在午夜过后，直到天空微微泛红之前，愿这位至尊人格守神保护。
May Lord Janardan, who carries a sword in his hand, protect me at the end of the night.
愿主 Janardan, 他在那手持利剑的主 Janardan, 在夜晚的末尾保护。
And may Lord Damodar protect me in the early morning.
愿主达摩达尔在清晨的时候保护我。
And may Lord Vishveshvara protect me during the junction of the day and night.
愿主 Vishveshvara 在白天与夜晚的交替时间保护我。
So next they talk about the Lord Sudarshan Chakra.
下面将讲述到主的苏大闪神碟。
So, it's set into motion by the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
它是在主的命令下行动。
And it moves in all four directions.
它漫游于四面八方。
And it has very sharp edges, which they can destroy, just like the fire.Of devastation at the end of the millennium.
它锋利无比，就像每一个千年的末期毁灭之火一样，具有毁灭性。
So just like the fire can burn dry grass to ashes, when there's a little breeze, the fire will burn dry grass to ashes.
就好像一场熊熊大火能在微风的协助下能够将干草烧成灰烬一样。
So we pray that the Sudarshan Chakra will also burn our enemies to ashes.
我们愿那位 Sudarshan Chakra 保护我们，将我们的敌人焚成灰烬。
Then pray to the club, because the Lord has different symbols in his hands, right?So the first one was the Sudarshan Chakra. Now we're praying to the club, which is also in the hand of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
主的身上有八件武器，先是 Sudarshan Chakra 神碟，我们现在向主的神锤祈求保护。
So we say that the club can produce sparks of fire, just like a thunderbolt.
就像主的神锤，它能够如火化，如同闪电一样有力。
And we know you are very dear to the Supreme Lord.
我们知道，神锤它对主来说非常亲切。
So we pray, you know, we pray to the club. We say, I am also His servant. So kindly help me to defeat my enemies.
我们向这位神锤，向主的神锤祈祷。我们说，我们也是主的仆人，也请你帮助我们能够打败我的敌人。
As we want to defeat all the evil living beings.
我们想击败那些邪恶的生物体。
So please, dear club, you please help us to pulverize them.
亲爱的神锤啊，请帮助我们彻底粉碎他们。
So next we pray to the conch shell, We see all best of the conch shells. Lord Krishna, Lord Narayana's conch shell is called Panchajanya.
接着我们向主的海螺祈祷，最佳的海螺啊，主手中的 Panchajanya。
And we know you are always filled with the breath of Lord Krishna.
您总是充满着主的气息。
And when Lord Krishna blows into the conch shell, produces a very frightening sound vibration, which causes all the enemies, all Krishna's enemies, they all tremble and fear.
因此，您制造出一种令人恐惧的气息，让这种声震令敌人胆战心惊。
And then next we pray to the sword which is held in the hand of the Supreme Lord.
现在我们向主手中的那把利剑向他祈祷。
We pray, please cut all the soldiers of our enemies to pieces.
请把我的敌人砍成碎片。
And we pray to the shield.That please cover the eyes of the sinful enemies, pluck out their sinful eyes.
接着，我们向主的这个盾，向他祈祷，请盖住敌人罪恶的双眼。
Then may the glorification of the name.Form, qualities, and paraphernalia of Krishna protect us from inauspicious situations like bad planets.
愿至尊人格首身超然的名字、形体、品质、随身用品的荣耀保护我们免于不吉祥的这些影响。
Right. There are many inauspicious situations mentioned, like envious human beings, and snakes and scorpions, animals like tigers and wolves.
有很多不吉祥的这些动物啊，或者提到这些东西，比如说这里有嫉妒的人，蛇、蝎子、豺狼。
And by glorifying your holy name, will it please help us to protect us from ghosts and from the material elements?
请愿这荣耀保护我们免于鬼魂和各种物质元素的影响。
And protect us from the lightning and from our past sins.
愿这荣耀能够保护我们免受霹雳和过往罪恶的影响。
We're always afraid of these things giving us problems.
我们总是担心这些事情给我们带来麻烦。
So please let them all be destroyed by our chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra.
愿他们都彻底的被 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗摧毁。
And Lord Garuda, he's the carrier of Lord Vishnu. So he is as powerful as Lord Vishnu himself.
主 Vishnu 的座驾 Garuda, 他和主本人一样都非常有力量。
He is the personified Vedas, and he's worshipped by verses from the Vedas.
他是韦达金的化身。也被韦达金的这些诗句所崇拜。
So may he protect us from all dangerous situations.
愿他能够在所有的危难情况之中保护我们。
And may Lord Vishvakshena, another name of the Supreme Lord, may he protect us from all dangers.
愿主 Vishvakshena 能够保护我们摆脱所有的危难。
And may the Supreme Personality of Godhead's holy name, his form, his carriers, all his weapons, may they all protect our body, our intelligence, senses, mind, and life air from all the dangers.
愿至尊人格守神的圣名、超然形体、座驾，以及所有的武器，能够保护我们的智性、感官、心意和生命之气，保护我们免于所有的危难，在危难之中保护我们。
So Krishna's associates and Krishna's weapons, they're all spiritual. They're all personalities.
至尊人格守神的同游，他的武器以及他的座驾都是灵性的，且都是人格的。
So there's no difference between Krishna and his name and his form and his qualities and his weapons.
主和他的名字、形象、品质、武器等等之间毫无分别。
Everything in relation to Krishna is the same.It's of the same as spiritual.
一切和主本人有关联的都是同品质的，他们都是灵性的。
They're all doing service for Krishna in different forms.
他们在以各种不同的形体之间对主做的超然的服务。
So the cosmic manifestation is there's two that.We have a subtle manifestation and a gross manifestation. But the cosmic manifestation is material, but at the same time it's not different from the Supreme Lord.
有两种宇宙的创造展示，一种是精微的和第二种是粗糙的。这两种都是物质的，但尽管如此，它们和至尊人格守神没有分别。
Yeah, he is the cause of all causes.
因为至尊人格守神是终极的万源之源。
The cause is there also in the effect.
原因和结果实际上是一个。
So the absolute truth or the personality of Godhead can destroy all of our dangers.Just by his potencies, by his different parts, his different appearances.
至尊绝对真理，至尊人格守神，他能够摧毁我们所有的危难，因为他强大有力。
So we have to understand that the living entities and the material energy and the spiritual energy are all individual substances.
我们要了解至尊人格守神，个体生物、物质能量、灵性能量和整个创造都是单独的实体。
But in the ultimate analysis, there's one supreme.
而终极的分析，他们一起构成至尊的一。
So people who are advanced in knowledge, they can see unity in diversity.
所以在灵性知识上非常进步的人，他们能够在变化之中看到统一。
So advanced, those people who are advanced, they can see the decorations on the body of the Lord.And his name, his fame, and all of his forms and weapons, they're all manifestations of his potency.
对于那些进步的人，主的装饰物，他的名字，他的声望，他的品质，以及他的形体，以及手中的武器，都是主能力的力量的展示。
So,They have different positions. Some are more elevated spiritually than others.
有一些他们在灵性上会更高级，就是说理解的高度会更高一些。
But the Supreme Lord is over everyone.
但是至尊主他是在所有人之上。
So we pray to him to protect us from all the dangers.
我们祈祷他，我们向他祈祷，愿他保护我们免于所有的危难。
So somebody who is actually advanced in spiritual knowledge, they can understand that nothing exists except Krishna.
有一些高度灵性理解力的人，他们可以理解，除了至尊主之外，没有其他。
Krishna says the same in the Bhagavad Gita in the 9th chapter.
主 Krishna 在博迦梵歌的第九章也说了。
Maya tatam idam sarvam, that everything is my energy. Krishna said, everything is my energy.
主 Krishna 说，一切都是我的能量。
Just like a fire is in one place, but the heat and light, they go everywhere.
就像火在一处，但是它的光和热可以扩展至每个地方。
So the same way, the Supreme Lord, He's in one place, but His energy is everywhere.
同样的，主虽然在一个地方，但是他的能量却在每一个地方。
And there's no difference between the cause and the effect.
原因和结果之间没有区别。
So the ornaments and the weapons of Krishna are all expansions of his spiritual energy, and they're not different from him.
主的装饰，因此主的装饰物、武器，由于这些都是主的灵性能量的扩展，也就与主本人没有区别。
There's no difference between Krishna and his different energies.
主 Krishna 本人和他的能量没有区别。
Just like the Lord's holy name is not different from Krishna.
就像主的圣名和主，就像主 Krishna 的圣名和主 Krishna 本人也没有区别。
Devotee was giving the lecture. He said, "Krishna is in His holy name," and Prabhupada said, "No." He said, "Krishna is His name. They're not different."
奉献者在讲课的时候说 ，Krishna 在他的圣名之中。圣帕帕的说，不 ，Krishna 就是那个圣名。
So we see here, we're offering a prayer to the ornaments, the different ornaments and carriers of the Supreme Lord.
我们在这里荣耀了主的，不同的这些物品以及主的座驾。
Yeah, and these things they're just as good as the Supreme Lord Himself.
他们都非常好，和主本人一样。
Because the Supreme Lord's in everything, and He's in everything's in Him.
主在所有之中，一切又在主之中。
So if we worship the weapons, it has the same effect as worshiping the Lord.
我们崇拜主的武器和崇拜主本人是一样的。
Of course, the Mayavadis, they don't accept this. They don't accept the form of the Lord.
但是这些 Mayavadi 他们不这么想，他们也不认为，主的形体。他们拒绝接受主的形体。
But we accept. We say the Lord's original form and His impersonal expansion are the same. They're one.
但是我们接受主的人格的形体，我们接受主的人原初的形体，以及主的非人格的这个光灿是一个。
So this prayer is saying, may that Lord who is everywhere in all different forms protect us everywhere.
愿便于各个形体之中的主在每一个地方保护我。
So the Lord is present everywhere by His name, by His form, His qualities.
主以他的名字、形体和品质、属性遍存万有。
So they all have equal power to protect the devotee.
他们都拥有同等的力量保护。 护着至尊，保护着奉献者。
Okay, so we will stop here.
好，我们停在这儿。
So any questions?
No question.
No questions?
Yeah.
Maybe we should keep going. What do you think? Oh, anyway.
不对，我问一个问题，可以吗？
可以。
嗯，就是这里讲到原因和结果是一样的，是只是在应用在今天的文。这个部分还是说我们可以在其他部分也这么怎么样去理解呢 ？Today we said the cause and the effect are the same. How can we understand it?
No, we didn't say they're the same, but we said the cause is in the effect.
The cause is
in the it's in the effect.
嗯，原因在结果之中。
So the initial cause of something, just like, what's it? You know, something happens. There's a reason for it, right?
Mm.
There's a reason for everything happening. What's the cause of, what was the cause of this? What's the cause of the rain today? Why did it rain today?We may say it like that, or why is it so hot today? There's a cause. What's the cause? The cause. So the cause, we could say, well, we could say about the cause, so the cause of the heat, because the sun came out, there were no clouds, there was no black rain clouds today, so the sun came out, so it was very hot.So we could say the cause was the sun. But what is the effect? The effect is the heat, and the heat is coming from the sun.
Mm. Hmm? 我们今天说的原因和结果不，就是说，是一，其实这更应该理解为。原因在结果之中，就像，为什么今天会为什么今天会有雨？为什么会今天会下雨呢？因为有云。为什么这个东西会很热呢？因为太阳出来了。太阳出来了，又导致了这个热。
So the effect is always.Has some relationship to the cause.
结果总是和原因有一些关联的。
Thank you, sir. Guru Maharaj.
Yes.
我想问，就是今天讲的那个第八到第十十节当中。就说到把那六个音节组成的那个 Om Vishnave Namaha 每个音节放在不同的位置上就心脏啊头顶这个是用冥想的方式吗
No You have to do it You have to say each syllable You have to touch different parts of the body
就是在唱诵这个音节的时候需要触碰身体的每一个部分
Of course you could say it's meditation I mean, but you don't just do it in your mind you actually do it you have to physically do it
不是说只是在心意上这么做实际在躯体上也得这么做
This is the Axman This is for the purification at the beginning, before you chant the mantra.
这个是属于一种净化，在你唱诵这个曼陀罗之前的一个净化。
There's different processes of doing Akshman. We do something very simple. We just take 3 drops and we chant Om Keshavaya Namaha, Om Narayana Namaha, Madhavaya Namaha. We chant like that, 3 drops, right? Om Keshavaya Namaha, Om Narayana Namaha, Madhavaya Namaha, and then Om Vishnave Namaha. But here in the Bhagavatam, it's describing a more complex Akshman.
我们平常做的这个阿彻曼就是净化净手啊，这个仪式净身体这个仪式非常简单，我们就唱3个曼陀罗 Om Narayana Namaha Om Keshava， 就是3滴水，就是念3个曼陀罗这样的这个阿彻曼。但是这个圣典博伽瓦坛今天我们学的这个，它是一个比较复杂的这个阿彻曼净化仪式。
So if you see Pankajangari, if you see Janani Vasprabhu to the Akshman, probably he does like that.
或许像 Janani Vasprabhu 就是这个马雅普庙宇的祭师，他们在做这个祭祀的，在做这个阿彻曼的时候，就会像这个瓦坛里面描述的这么复杂一点。
Yeah, every morning before they go on the altar to serve the deity, they will do it like this Akshman.
每一天早上在去见神像的时候，他们可做在给神像做服务的时候，他们会用这个阿彻曼。
And they chant these different syllables and they touch the different parts of the body.
他们唱不同的音节，然后触碰身体的不同的部分。
那么这一章就是这个拿的，那里亚纳卡瓦查后面讲的所有的这些保护的内容，也是我们也是通过冥想这种祈祷的方式来做的吗？
Yeah, if you want to do the whole, if you want to get the protection of the Narayana Kavacha, you do first the Akshman and then you chant all these prayers.
就是前面唱的这些曼陀罗是属于一个阿彻曼，就是净化部分，然后后面的这些祈祷这个部分是属于Narayana Kavacha的这个祈祷文部分。如果我们想得到主Narayana Kavacha这个盾的保护的话，我们得做整个这个程序，前面的净化加后面的祈祷。
It's quite, we didn't finish the chapter yet. There's still more. It goes up to text number 42.
我们还没有把这个讲完，它后面还会有这个祈祷。
So you have to chant each of the mantras, all the mantras, all the verses.
所以你如果要做的话，得把所有的这个祈祷文全以及曼陀罗都要。
And you should chant them in Sanskrit and in Chinese.
先是梵文。然后再是中文。
Because when we chant, we should know the meaning of what we're chanting.
因为你在唱诵的时候，你需要理解你唱诵的这些梵文的意思，所以先是你唱诵一遍梵文，然后再唱诵中文。
好的，谢谢
Gurudev。I remember.The devotees were all chanting Narayana Kavacha. It happened, it was a long time ago, and I was in India at the time. It was in Mumbai. In Mumbai, there was a big problem, there was a big crisis, and there was a lot of trouble. So the devotees, some of the devotees, they were chanting this Narayana Kavacha every day.
当初我在孟买的时候，就是很早些年的时候，我在孟买的时候，当初有很多奉献者就在，因为那个时候有很多的麻烦，很多的问题在孟买发生，所以我记得当时有很多奉献者就在唱诵这个 Narayana Kavacha。
Yeah, some devotees were in danger, you know, they were in danger, they were maybe going to have to go to jail or something, so they were chanting this Narayana Kavacha.
还有一些奉献者非常处于非常危险的这个状况之中，比如说去了监狱啊什么样的这样的事情，他们也唱诵这个哪吒样的卡巴唱。
It's a good meditation.
这也是一个很好的冥想。
Of course, you could say, well, we just chant Hare Krishna. Yes, we do.
当然，我们也可以只唱 Hare Krishna， 这个也是我们现在在做的。
But there's no harm if you can get more protection.By chanting Narayana Kavacha, then you should do that also.
如果你想得到更多的保护，想唱这个 Narayana Kavacha 也是可以的。Good day. Here have some other questions.
Okay.
Okay. First from Gopinath Priya, 顶拜姑的莲花组，主身上的光灿也是主吗？Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. The effulgent of the Lord is also the Lord himself.
Well, it's the energy of the Lord.
那个是主的能量。
Mm-hmm. We would say it's the impersonal feature of the Lord.
我们说那是主的非人格的能量，非人格的特征。
Mm-hmm.It's not. We don't think of it as being like a personality, like the different weapons of the Lord are personalities.
Sorry.
The Brahma Jyoti is not like it's not like it's not like the Lord's weapons.Or the Lord's paraphernalia.
主的这个光灿，光灿的梵光部分，它和主的武器以及随身用品是不一样的。
Yeah, it's not impersonal. It's not a personality. It's impersonal. So it's the Lord's potency.
主的光灿它是非人格的，是因此是主的能量部分。
Of course, it's a feature of the absolute truth.
当然这也是绝对真理的一个特征。
The Srimad Bhagavatam says, Vedanti tat tat vamvijam tat vamyajnanam advayam brahmati paramatmati bhagavan iti shabyate.The transcendentalists who know the absolute truth, they call this non-dual substance as Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan.
至尊的这些超然主义者称至尊绝对真理有三个部分，第一是梵光、超灵以及薄伽梵，这是至尊绝对真理的三个方便。
So it's one with Krishna, but at the same time different from him.
这也是 Krishna 的一部分，它也是跟 Krishna 合一，但是也是和 Krishna 是不同的。
That's our philosophy. Everything is one and different.
我们的哲学也是这样，即一即异，每一个是一，但是又是不同的。
So the Brahma Jyoti is like that. It's one with Krishna, but at the same time different.
所以梵光就是这样特征，它和主是一，但是它跟主本人又不同。
Uh-huh. Good question.
非常好的问题。Next question from Mathur, from 张云昌 Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤儿和所有的奉献者。我们人类在所有的生物中不是最高级的，那为什么至尊主要选择做人格的人格化的？Hare Krishna, basis to Guru and all devotees. if the human being is not the highest in the all the living entities, so why the Lord choose to be personalized?
Why do you think the human being is not the highest?
你为什么会认为人类不是在生物中最高级的呢？
Even the demigods, they want to come and take birth on this planet as human beings.
即便是高等星球的这些半世人，他也想在地球上投生为人类。
Because it's the best place to go back to Godhead.
因为这个地方是回归守神的最好的地方。
The higher planets may have opulence and they may have powers which we don't have, but it's very difficult for them to go back to Godhead. They have to wait a long time.
高等的星宿或许有很高的便利条件，很多的富裕，但是要回归守神对于他们来说非常困难，他们需要等很长的时间。
And we see the Lord comes himself in this form. He comes as Lord Krishna himself. He brings his own abode here, Vrindavan, from the spiritual world. His own abodes are here.
我们看到主 Krishna 本人把他灵性世界的 Vrindavan 也带到了这里。
We don't see the Lord having his own abodes there in the higher planets.
我们并没有看到主 Krishna 他把他的居所放在这些高等星球上面。
The different demigods are there, but the Lord, the Supreme Lord himself, he comes here on this planet, he incarnates here on this planet, and he comes as a human being. What, just to attract all of us to go back to Godhead.
主本人来到的是这里，他不是去高等星球，他来到这里，然后上演他的逍遥时光，吸引所有的人回归守神。
He doesn't do these things anywhere else.
他没有在其他的地方去做这些事情。
It's his mercy on the people, the human beings on this planet, to give them a chance to go back to Godhead.
这是给予我们的仁慈以及机会，能够让我们回归守神的一次机会。给这个地球上的所，给这个星球上的所有的人。
His holy dham is here, Govardhan Hill is here, the Yamuna River is here. He brings all these things from the spiritual world just for his pastimes.
他把灵性世界的所有的一切都带来了，比如说戈尔瓦丹山、亚穆纳河，他所有的一切带来只是为了他的餐，只是为了他的逍遥时光。
Yeah. Okay. Next question.
Next question from Sugita Sangamadaji. Hare Krishna, 顶拜姑的莲花族，感恩翻译和主持人。我们有时候会参加朋友和家人的聚会，会跟非奉献者一起联谊。一般情况下，我会拒绝参加。请问姑乳，如果与非奉献者联谊，给他们带菩萨的，从心里希望他们能够让他们爱 Krishna。我对修习 Krishna 信心坚定，参加这样联谊不会使我堕落吧。Hare Krishna, basis to Guru's Lord's faith, and sometimes I will join the meeting between my friend and my families. So associate with the non-devotees. Normally I will reject their associations, but I want to ask,if I associate with these long devotees and giving them prasadam, and in my heart, I wish them to love Krishna. So, in this condition, I want to know if I join this association, whether I will fall or not.
No, this is, you're giving mercy. The more you give mercy, the more you get mercy.
不会堕落的。你越多的给予仁慈，你越多的得到仁慈。
Of course, don't become proud. You have to stay humble.
当然，不要骄傲，你应该保持谦卑。
By some good fortune, you're able to give them some mercy. You distribute Krishna prasadam to them. It's very nice.
由于某种幸运，你能够给予仁慈，给予 Krishna 的 prasadam， 给予他们，这是非常好的。
So try to give the mercy, and it's very.It's very good for us if we try to give mercy to others.
如果我们能够把仁慈给予其他人，这个对我们来说非常好。
Yeah.
Next question. Okay. Next question from Yogita Sharma. Hare Krishna, Gurudev. Please accept my humble obeisance. Gurudev, in Kali Yuga, we don't have good memory.For protection, we can just say the Maha Mantra, right? The Lord in the Bhagavad Gita, Name Bhaktiya Pranashati, my devotees never perish. So, or we can also say Nrisimha Arti or Nrisimha Kavacha. Basically, our faith and the Lord, and the Lord is there, and he can know of it as he is in the heart. So simply saying the Maha Mantra with the focus and attention would be sufficient, right? Hare Krishna, 这个是 Yogita Sharma 的问题。Hare Krishna, Gurudev, 请接受我卑微的顶拜。在卡利年代我们没有好的记忆力，为了保护我们只需要唱这个Maha Mantra, 就是 Hare Krishna Mantra, 是不是就可以了？在这个薄伽梵歌中说，我的奉献者不会毁灭。然后我们也唱了Nrisimha，或者说我们也可以唱这个Nrisimha的这个Arti Kavacha。通常情况下，我们只需要把注意力集中在这个 Maha Mantra 上，是不是就可以了，就足够了
？Yes, very good. Okay, if you have full faith in the holy name, you chant the Maha Mantra. You don't need to chant anything else.
是的，非常好。如果你有全部的信心在这个圣名上，只需要唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗就好了，不需要唱诵别的。Next question from Vaishnava Vani. My humble basis, Guru Maharaj. Many people in India chant the mantras without knowing the meaning. Also, they chant the Hanuman Kalisha.Om Narayana, Gayatri Mantra, and so on. They also chant the Hare Krishna Mantra along with this. I was wondering if this kind of practice will benefit them. Hare Krishna, 请接受我卑微的顶拜。很多人在印度的很多人唱诵曼陀罗，但是他们并不知道其中的含义。他们唱诵哈努曼的这个，以及 Narayana， 还有 Gayatri 等等。他们也同时也唱诵 Hare Krishna， 所以我在想他们的这种练习是否对他们有帮助。
Yes, certainly will be help. Will help them. It will attract the mercy of a devotee.
他们这样做肯定是有帮助的，他们会吸引奉献者的仁慈。
And a devotee will teach them the meaning and help them to understand what they're chanting.
然后奉献者会告诉他们，他们到底唱诵的曼陀罗的含义是什么。
So even though they don't understand the meaning, they get benefit.
即便他们不知道这些曼陀罗的含义，他们仍然会受益。
The holy name is so powerful that even though we don't understand, we get the benefit. Just like you take a medicine.You don't have to know about medicines. You don't have to understand what's happening. You just take the medicine. The medicine will act.
圣名是非常有力量的，即便他们不知道是什么含义，他们仍然会受益。 就比如说我们在吃药的时候，我们并不知道这个药的具体它是怎么样发挥作用，但是我们一吃药身上就会有反应，就会有疗效。因此我们唱诵这个曼陀罗，不知道益处也会有效。
嗯， okay.
Okay. And the next question from Shuddha Sindhu Devi Dasi. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj and all devotees. I'm a little bit confused. The chanting or recitation of the Narayana Kavacha from the Srimad Bhagavatam, is it just from the text 1 to number 42? Can we select, for example, text 13 to 38? Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj 和所有的奉献者，我有一些困惑，这个唱诵 Nishinha Narayana Kavacha 是从这个瓦坛的第一到四十二，还是说就是我们今天学的一到四十二节，还是说我们是否可以选择这个十三到三十八世纪？
Yeah, well, that's right. The prayer begins from 13. The actual prayer is beginning in number verse 13.
是的，这个祷文的真正，这个祷文的真正部分是从十三世节开始。
But you have the first 13 verses here describing how to do the Akshman.
前面的十三个诗节讲的是阿什曼净化部分。
So you have to do the Akshman before you chant all the prayers.
在你唱祷文之前，你得唱前面的阿什曼部分。
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Question finished.
Okay.Sawaman Ganshya Sabudhi Rai Prabhu Giwaman Jantaida Fani, Waman Ganshya Sawada Functionsa Ling Ting Tiwan, Waman Jufuni Man Jere Kwaila, Wanshut Rui, Dobao Jong Shinti, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki. Jai.
Bhakti Vedanta Nishinha Maharaj Ki Jai.
Gaur Bhakti.
Guru Singhula.
Sati Mataji Ki Jai.Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. 感谢所有朋友们的聆听，我们今天的网课就到这里结束了，明天再见。 Hare Krishna.